Hi guys, it's Aimee. Many of you guys were asking whether you should put your weight in the front foot or the back foot to chip around the green. So today I'm gonna go ahead and clarify that for you guys. When I started learning golf, I started with the 80 style, the old school style. So when I first learned to chip, my weight was more in the back foot and the ball position was more back in the stance. That was normal back in the day. But nowadays, everything is changing a little bit more scientifically. So they're leaning towards something that's more efficient, more consistent with better accuracy. So nowadays, more people are putting the weight in the forward foot, about 60%, and ball position is either in the middle or slightly left of the middle. That's normal. So when I turned professional, I had to make that change because the result of the modern ways was a lot better performance-wise. And it took me like a year and it was a hard change, but I am really glad I did make that change. I wanted to explain to you exactly what the concept behind that is. So basically from the ball to the target is about 15 yards. It's a very straightforward basic chip shot. Our motive here is to try and get this ball close to the target as much as possible. So we're hitting kind of like toward the desired target, right? So we start ideally with the weight 60% on the left. That's gonna give it nice descending angle into the ball, crisp and consistent contact with the club face, and nicer control with the spin rate, distance control, and accuracy, okay? So when we start with 60% on the left, even though there's not much movement going on, we're trying to hit the ball to the target, so we will naturally shift toward the target. So we will usually finish with about 80% weight in the front foot. So you go from 60 to 80, right? So if you set up with the weight in the back foot, ball position in the right, it's going to be about 40% on the left and 60% on the right. Even if you start this way, you're going to have to shift over toward the target. But for such a small shot, for you to go from 40% to 80% is such a huge movement. Sometimes it can startle you, throw you off, making you jerk through the impact. So that's why we don't want to start with a lot of weight on the right. It's too big of a move in the downswing. You're going to make too much mistake through the ball, right? So eventually, once you start making mistake in the downswing, you're going to start staying in the back foot instead of shifting through, which is what we need to do, right? So you stay back, and this is the most common mistake of chipping off the right foot. A lot of people rock backwards. And what happens? You can either catch the ball on top and scull it across, or you can hit behind the ground and hit it fat. And once you start rocking back this way and your contact becomes inconsistent, you're going to start getting hesitant through impact, and you're gonna start manipulating your impact with your hands, and just everything goes wrong from there. So I wanted to show you the whole shifting through concept with a bucket of water. So let me go ahead and show you that. So I have a bucket of dirty water here and I'm trying to chuck it down my driveway, right? So my desired target is that way. So when you throw this water, obviously you're gonna shift toward the target so you don't get any water on yourself, right? All right, let's see it. Right? You will probably most likely not rock back and chuck this way. I'm so glad there's no water in there because I would have gotten a shower, right? So you don't want to rock the other direction of desired target when you're throwing water or hitting the golf ball that way. So you want to shift toward the target, and I want you to understand this concept of chipping through, so you're shifting to the forward foot. That's why you don't want to start with a lot of weight in the back foot, because the rocking back happens a lot. So we want 60% in the leading foot. And I have 80% in the finish. So I hope that concept really helped you understand that you need to start with the weight in the forward foot to make that downswing transition a lot smoother, resulting in consistent contact and accuracy. I hope you're able to follow along. If you have any questions, please come to Ask Aimee section and leave your comments and questions there. I'll get back to you guys on that. Thanks guys for watching. I'll see you guys in the next lesson.